How do these stabbings relate to Israel? Joining me now to discuss is Middle East analyst, Time of Israel blogger, and former IDF soldier, Micah Danzik. Thanks so much for joining the program, Micah.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me, Lawrence.
Micah, why does this keep happening? And how do this particular incident, how does that relate to Israel?
Well, I've written about this many times before, and we've often heard from people who are dialed in, so to speak, to these issues that Israel and the Jewish people have always been the canary in the coal mine. What we've seen historically is that often the people who hate the most, who have the most, you know, frankly, evil in their heart, the first target of their hate is the Jews, the Jewish people. We saw that with the Nazis and with Nazism. Their first target were the Jews, and largely throughout the Western world and the rest of the world, people excused the Nazi hatred of the Jews. They made they talked about the frustration of the German people and how they were just all this hatred was a result of how they were treated during World War I or in the aftermath of World War I, and we ignored that hatred when it was directed at the Jewish people. Today, we see those same things manifesting themselves in with Israel being the, quote, Jew among nations, and we see how people treat terrorism against Jews as different than terrorism elsewhere, and we see how what starts with the Jews.
But why do they treat it differently?
Well, we can go into an entire, analysis of the history of anti-Semitism in the world. It's the oldest form of bigotry that has survived to this very day. 2,000 years of anti-Semitism in Europe, over 1,400 years of anti-Semitism in the Arab world under Islam, where the first ghettos formed by for Jews was actually not in Europe but in the Middle East. But the reality is what we see, and I think this is an issue of fighting this terrorism and making sure we defeat it, is that we didn't defeat the scourge of Nazism until we realized the Nazis were coming for all of us.